Good morning, students of class 3. Students, I hope all of you are well and in a cheerful mood, ready for the English class. Students, today I'm going to continue with lesson 6 of your Wordsworth English Reader book, Jack Discovers a New Land. As told earlier, this is the second part of lesson 5, Jack and the Beanstalk. Students, please take out your Wordsworth English Reader book and turn to page number 51, lesson 6, Jack Discovers a New Land. Students, today I'll be reading the lesson for you, explaining the content and discussing the vowels along with their word meanings. Please listen to me carefully as I read this lesson. Lesson 6, Jack Discovers a New Land. When the beanstalk ended, Jack found himself in front of a great castle with a broad road leading straight up to the front gate. As he drew near the castle, he saw a huge lady standing at the door. Jack was scared at the sight of the lady, but he asked, "Would you please, ma'am, give me some breakfast? I have had nothing to eat since yesterday." The giant's wife was very kind. She said, "Very well, little man, come in, but you must be quick about it. If my husband, the giant, finds you here, he will eat you up, bones and all." "Here is a cup of milk and some sandwiches." Suddenly, there was a loud knock at the front door, which seemed to shake even the thick walls of the castle. The giant's wife quickly lifted Jack up and popped him into an empty kettle when her husband roared out, "Fee, fi, fo, fum, I smell the blood of a young one. Be he alive or be he dead, I'll grind his bones to make my bread. It's a boy, I'm sure it is," he continued. "Where is he? I'll have him for my breakfast." "Nonsense," said his wife. "You must be mistaken. It's the ox hide you smell." Thus the giant sat down and ate a greater part of the ox. When he had finished, he said, "Wife, bring me my money bags." His wife brought him 2 bags of gold, and the giant began to count his money. Jack watched in wonder at all that was happening. The giant then asked his wife to fetch his little hen, which laid golden eggs. The hen laid 20 golden eggs. After the giant had put the eggs into a basket, he called out, "Wife, bring me the golden lion." His wife brought the golden lion and placed it on the table. "Sing," said the giant, and the lion at once began to sing the most beautiful songs that ever were heard. It sang so sweetly that the giant soon fell fast asleep. Seeing that the giant was fast asleep, Jack crept quietly out of the kettle and tiptoed to the table. He gathered the money bags and the little hen. He put them into a large bag, and just as he lifted the golden lyre, the hen called out, "Master, master." The giant woke up just in time to catch sight of Jack running out of the kitchen door with his money and hen. With a fearful roar, he screamed, "Fee, fi, fo, fum, I spy a country bum. He's alive, but will soon be dead. When I grind his bones to make my bread." He grabbed his club and dashed after Jack, who was already halfway down the beanstalk. The giant began to climb down too. But as soon as Jack saw him coming, he called out, "Mother, bring me an egg." Jack had no sooner reached the ground when he chopped the beanstalk. Down came the giant with a terrible crash, and that was the end of him. With the bags of gold and little hen, Jack and his mother held the entire village. All the villagers blessed them and lived happily ever after. Students, this was the reading. Now I discuss the vowels along with their meaning. Students, the first new word of the lesson is castle. C-A-S-T-L-E, castle. And castle means palace. Castle means palace. Castle, palace. Castle, palace. Then the second word is pot. The second word is pot. And pot means to put something inside. P-O-P-P-E-D, pot. Pot means to put something inside. P-O-P-P-E-D, pot. Pot means to put something inside. The third word is road. R-O-A-R-E-D, road. And road means shouted loudly. Road means shouted loudly. Road shouted loudly. Students, the fourth word is grind. G-R-I-N-D, grind. Grind means crush into small pieces. Crush means to break. Grind means crush into small pieces. Grind means crush into small pieces. Break into small pieces or crush so fine like a powder. Then the fifth word is mistaken. M-I-S-T-A-K-E-N. M-I-S-T-A-K-E-N, mistaken, means to be wrong. Mistaken means to be wrong. Galat samajh lena. That is known as mistaken. M-I-S-T-A-K-E-N, mistaken. Students, the sixth word is ox hide. That is the skin of an ox. Ox, apostrophe S. There's an apostrophe S after ox, which means that the hide was of ox. This apostrophe, this shows the position. Ki wo beta hide skin. Skin kiski thi? ox ki thi. So ox hide means skin of an ox. Then the seventh word is wonder. The seventh word is wonder. W-O-N-D-E-R, wonder. Wonder means surprise. W-O-N-D-E-R, wonder. Wonder means surprise. The eighth word is fetch. F-E-T-C-H, fetch means to bring. Leke aana. The eighth word is fetch. F-E-T-C-H, fetch. In this, students, T is silent. Pronounce it fetch. T is silent. So, fetch means to bring. Fetch means to bring. Then the ninth word is lyre. L-Y-R-E, lyre. Lyre is a musical string instrument. What is a lyre? A musical string instrument. Lyre, a musical string instrument. Then the tenth word is crept. The tenth word is crept. And crept means walked quietly. Crept means walked quietly. Walk without making any noise. Walked quietly. C-R-E-P-T. Crept means walk quietly. Then the 11th word is tiptoed. P-I-P-T-O-E-D. Toad. Tiptoed. Tiptoed means, students, walked very silently. Same meaning as of crept, walked quietly or walked without making any noise. That is, walked very silently without making any noise. Then the 12th word is fearful. F-E-A-R-F-U-L. Fearful. Fearful means scary, which makes you scared, which makes you frightened. So fearful means scary, which makes you scared or frightened. Jisko dekke beta dar lage, that is known as fearful. Then the 13th word is screamed. S-C-R-E-A-M-E-D, screamed. S-C-R-E-A-M-E-D, screamed. Scream means shouted loudly. Scream means shouted loudly. Scream means shouted loudly. Students, you need to remember that screams meaning is also shouted loudly and roared meaning is also shouted loudly. These two words have got the same meaning. Screamed also means shouted loudly. Then students, the 14th word is spy. Spy means to see. Spy means to see. Spy means to see. Then the 15th word is club. The 15th word is club. C-L-U-B, club. Here, club means a heavy stick which is thick at one end. A heavy, heavy matlab bhari. A stick which is thick. Thick matlab ek end se wo thodi moti hai. Stick ke do ends hote hai. Aur ek end se jo moti ho usko bolenge club. A heavy stick which is thick at one end. So that kya us side se if you hit someone, that will hurt the person. So club is a heavy stick which is thick at one end. Students, the 16th word is dash. D-A-S-H-E-D, dash. D-A-S-H-E-D, dash. And dash means run fast. Dash means run fast. Dash means ran fast. Then the 17th word is chop. C-H-O-P-P-E-D, chopped. C-H-O-P-P-E-D, chopped means to cut into small pieces. Chote chote pieces mein cut karna. That is known as chopped. To cut into small pieces. And the 18th word is terrible. The 18th word is terrible. T-E-R-R-I-B-L-E, terrible. Terrible means horrible or very. So students, these were the wow words. That is the new words of the lesson, students. Now, please, in your English notebook, please do write the vowel words and learn the spellings. After writing the vowel words, students, please write the word meanings. Below the vowel words, draw a parting line and write the word meaning so that when you read the word, you come to know what is the meaning. Now, students, there are two phrases also given in the lesson. There are two phrases given in the lesson that also you all need to write and know the meaning. I'll write those words. Meaning of the phrases. The first one is at the sight of. At the sight of means on seeing someone. At the sight of means on seeing someone. Kisiko dekhna. At the sight of, on seeing someone. And second is to catch sight of. Sight means to see. In both the phrases, students, the word sight is there and sight means see. To catch sight of, to see someone or something. To see someone or something. So, at the sight of, on seeing someone, kisi ko dekhna. And the second is to catch sight of, kisi cheech ko, to see something or someone, kisi ko ya kisi cheech ko dekhna. So, these are the two phrases of the lesson. You need to write this below the word meanings. Now, students, I'll be explaining the lesson once again so that you understand it. Students, when the beanstalk ended, what happened? Jack, he discovered a new land. And this lesson is all about what Jack sees there. When Jack climbed the beanstalk, what did he see? When the beanstalk ended, Jack found himself in front of a great castle with a broad road leading straight up to the front gate. The moment Jack climbed the beanstalk, what did he see? He saw a great castle which had a broad road in front of it. And Jack walked on that wide broad road and he reached the castle. As he drew near the castle, he saw a huge lady standing at the door. And as Jack walked near the castle, what did he see? He saw a huge, very big lady standing at the door of the castle. Jack was scared at the sight of the lady. When Jack saw that lady in front of that castle's door, he got scared because that lady was very big. But then Jack gathered courage and he asked that lady. He asked, "Would you please, ma'am, give me some breakfast? I have had nothing to eat since yesterday." Jack asked that lady very politely that, "Would you, ma'am, please give me some breakfast? I have not had anything to eat since yesterday." Why he didn't have anything? Because he had exchanged his cow for a handful of magic beans. He didn't get any money, so he could not buy any food. The giant's wife. This is the huge lady. The giant's wife was very kind. She said, "Very well, little man, come in. But you must be quick about it. If my husband, the giant, finds you here, he will eat you up bones and all. Here is a cup of milk. Answer, sandwiches. Now that huge lady, giant's wife, though she was very big, but she was very kind-hearted. So she said, okay, fine. I'll give you something to eat, but then you must hurry up. Why? You have to be very quick. Why? Because if her husband, the giant, comes back and if he sees you, what will that giant do? Her husband, the giant, will eat you up. He'll eat the bones also. Go pura ke pura kha jayega. Bones bhi kha jayega. So she said, ki very well, you come. I'll give you something to eat, but then you must hurry up. Before, you should eat it before my husband comes. And what did she give Jack to eat? She gave him a cup of milk and some sandwiches. All of you are fond of sandwiches, I know, isn't it? Suddenly, there was a loud knock at the front door, which seemed to shake even the thick walls of the castle. Suddenly, when Jack was eating, what happened? There was a loud knock at the door of the castle. And the knock was so loud that it seemed that the walls of the castle, they were shaking. The giant's wife quickly lifted Jack up and popped him into an empty kettle when her husband rode up. When the giant's wife, she came to know that her husband is back, what did she do? She picked up Jack. Jack was very small compared to her size. So she picked Jack up and she popped him in the kettle so that the giant could not see that somebody else was there in the castle. And the giant, he came inside. And he shouted loudly, "Fee, fi, fo, fum, I smell the blood of a young one. Be he alive or be he dead, I'll grind his bones to make my bread." Now the giant had entered his castle and he shouted, "Fee, fi, fo, fum, I smell the blood of a young one." He said ki mujhe kisi young one means kisi child ke blood ke smell aa rahi hai. Be alive. Either the child is alive or dead. I'll kill him, grind him, and with that grind bones, I'll make my bread. That's what the giant shouted loudly. "It's a boy, I'm sure it is," he continued. "Where is he? I'll have him for my breakfast." The giant, he said that the smell which I can smell, the smell of the blood, and I'm sure that the smell of blood is of a young boy. "Where is he? Kaha hai wo? I'll have him for my breakfast." The giant wanted to grind Jack's bone and make bread out of it and then have the bread for breakfast. "Nonsense," said his wife. "You must be mistaken." His wife said that, "Nonsense, you are wrong. There is no one over here. It's the ox hide you smell. The smell of the blood which you can smell, it's not the smell of a young one, it's the smell of the ox skin." Because the giant used to eat animals, any creature, any living being. So the wife said, "Ki ye jo smell aa rahi hai, ye kisi young one ki nahi, ye kiski hai? Ox ke skin ki hai." Thus the giant sat down and ate a greater part of the ox. So the giant thought, okay, the smell what I'm getting, this is the smell of the oxide. So he sat and then he started eating that oxide and he ate a big part of the ox hide. Usne ek bahut bada part oxide ka khaya. When he had finished, he said, and when he had finished eating, what did he say to his wife? "Wife, bring me my money bags." He told his wife, "Go and get my money bags." His wife brought him two bags of gold and the giant began to count his money. What did his wife do? She brought in 2 bags of gold. And the giant said and started counting his money. The money was all gold coins as seen in the picture. Jack watched in wonder at all that was happening. Now Jack, he was hiding inside that kettle and he was watching, because everything was very strange for him. He was very poor. He had never seen such a big castle. He had never seen such huge people. So he was watching everything in surprise. Everything was new for him. So he was watching. The giant then asked his wife to fetch his little hen, which laid golden eggs. What did the giant do after counting his money? He told his wife, "Go get my little hen." And what happened? The wife brought the little hen. The hen laid 20 golden eggs. How many eggs did the hen lay? 20 golden eggs. When his wife brought the little hen, that hen was not an ordinary hen. It was a special hen. So the hen, why it was special? Because the hen laid 20 golden eggs. How many eggs did the hen lay? 20. Were they ordinary eggs? No. They were eggs made out of gold. 20 golden eggs that hen laid. After the giant had put the eggs into a basket, he called out, "Wife, bring me the golden lie." First he told his wife to bring the money bags. He counted his money. After that, he told his wife to get the little hen. That hen laid 20 golden eggs. That giant, what did he do? He kept those eggs in a basket and then ordered his wife to go and get his golden lyre. Lyre is a musical instrument. But that giant's lyre was also special. It was made of gold. So that's the reason it is called golden lyre. His wife brought the golden lyre and placed it on the table. His wife brought the golden lyre and kept it on the table where the giant was there. "Sing," said the giant. And the lyre at once began to sing the most beautiful songs that were ever heard. And the moment the giant ordered the lyre to sing, what happened? The lyre, it started singing the most beautiful songs that were ever heard. Jo beta kisi ne kabhi nahi sune the, itte beautiful songs the. The most beautiful songs. It sang so sweetly that the giant soon fell fast asleep. And when the lyre started singing the beautiful songs, what happened? The giant, he slept quickly. Now, Jack was looking everything from inside that kettle. So when he saw that the giant was asleep, what did he do? Seeing that the giant was asleep, Jack crept quietly out of the kettle and tiptoed to the table. Jack came out of the kettle and slowly he walked on the tip of his toes on the table. And what did he do? He gathered means collected, sab ikhatta kar lena. He gathered the money bags and the little hen. He put them in a large bag. And just as he lifted the golden lyre, the hen called out, "Master, master." Ab Jack ne dekha ki giant to so gaya hai. What did he do? Usne jaldi se wo nikla. And dheere, without making any noise, he tiptoed on the table. And then what did he do? He collected the money bags and the hen. And he kept these things in a big bag. And what happened? The moment the Jack, he picked up the golden lyre also, what happened? The hen, which was inside the bag, called out, "Master, master." She was calling out the giant, because giant was a master. And hearing the hen's voice, what happened? The giant, he woke up. The giant woke up just in time to catch sight of Jack running out of the kitchen door with his money and hen. And beta, jaise hen ne chillaya, "Master, master," what happened? Jack was running. He had carried all the things, kept it in his bag, the money bags, the hand and the golden lyre in his hand, and he was running. And जैसे ही वो किचन डोर से बाहर निकलने था, एट द सेम टाइम द जायंट ही सॉ जैक रनिंग विद ऑल हिज थिंग्स. सो ही गॉट वेरी एंग्री. हु गॉट एंग्री? द जायंट. विद अ फियरफुल रोर ही स्क्रीम्ड एंड आउट ऑफ एंगर ही शाउटेड लाउडली. हु शाउटेड लाउडली? द जायंट, बिकॉज जैक वॉज रनिंग विद ऑल हिज बिलोंगिंग्स. Fee, fi, fo, fum. I spy a country bum. And he again roared out, fee, fi, fo, fum. I spy. Spy means see. He had seen Jack running out of the kitchen door. So he says, I've seen a country bum. Now country bum here, bum means a young boy. And country means a boy from a village. Not from a town or a city, but a village. And this country bum refers to the young boy Jack. He is alive. The giant saw Jack running, so he came to know that the young boy is alive. But the giant shouted, "He will soon be dead." That means the giant wanted to kill Jack. When I grind his bones to make my bread. The giant wanted to kill Jack, grind his bones and make bread out of Jack's bone and then eat that bread. He grabbed his club. Beta, grab karna, aise uthana. Giant ne apna jo club hai, that heavy stick which is thick at one end, usko uthaya. Because he wanted to hit Jack with his club. So he grabbed his club and ran quickly after Jack. He wanted to catch hold of Jack because he was running with the belongings of the giant. तो उसको giant को, Jack को पकड़ना था, तो giant ने अपना club, मोटी वाली छड़ी उठाई, भारी वाली, and he ran after Jack. But by the time Jack had already climbed down half of the beanstalk. But जब तक giant भागता, Jack beanstalk से उतर के halfway, आधे रस्ते beanstalk के आ गया था. The giant began to climb down from the beanstalk too. But as soon as Jack saw him coming, he called out, "Mother, bring me a nut." But जैसे ही जैक ने देखा कि the giant is also following him, chase कर रहा है उसको पकड़ने के लिए, he called out to his mother, "Mother, bring me an axe." मेरे लिए एक एक्स कुल्हाड़ी लेके आओ. Why he wanted an axe? Because he wanted to cut the beanstalk, chop it so that the giant will fall down from the high. And Jack had no sooner reached the ground when he chopped the beanstalk. अब जैक जैसे ही ग्राउंड पे पहुंचा, what did he do? With that axe, he chopped the beanstalk. उसने beanstalk को क्या किया? चॉप कर दिया अपनी एग से. एंड व्हाट हैपेंड? द जायंट वाज ऑन द बीनस्टॉक ओनली. और जब बीनस्टॉक कटा तो क्या हुआ बेटा? जायंट ऊपर से धड़ाम से ही फेल डाउन. डाउन केम द जायंट विद अ टेरिबल क्रश. धड़ाम से, जोर से, बहुत जोर से गिरा. एंड दैट वाज द एंड ऑफ हिम. दैट मींस आफ्टर फॉलिंग डाउन व्हाट हैपेंड? द जायंट ही die. And now Jack had collected the giant's money bag, that the two bag full of money, gold coins, the hen, little hen which laid golden eggs, and the golden lion. And with all that gold and money, Jack and his mother helped the entire village. Beta, jis village mein Jack aur uski mother rehte the, उन्होंने उस पूरे विलेज की हेल्प की विद द मनी जैक हैड ब्रॉट फ्रॉम द जायंट्स कैसल. एंड ऑल द विलेजर्स, दे वर सो हैप्पी टू हैव मनी एंड गोल्ड, सो दे ऑल ब्लेस्ड जैक एंड हिज मदर. एंड आफ्टर दैट एवरीबॉडी लिव्ड हैप्पीली. उसके बाद, बिकॉज नाउ जैक एंड हिज मदर हैड ऑल्सो बिकम रिच विद ऑल दैट मनी, सो एवरीबॉडी लिव्ड happily ever after. Hope students, you all have understood the story? That's all for today's class. Thank you. Have a good day ahead. Please do read this lesson